Iran is mourning the loss of Mohammad Reza Shajarian, the star of Persian traditional music. Tens of thousands of people filled the streets of Tehran after learning that Mohammad Reza Shajarian had died on October the 8th at the age of 80. His career spanned almost six decades. After Iran's government banned Western music in 1979, he became a sensation. He was banned from performing inside the country in 2009, though, for supporting opposition groups during the street protests. His legacy could be felt as the thousands of mourners in Iran's capital this week chanted anti-governmental slogans. Marian Bremer, journalist and researcher of Persian culture, now joins me. Hello, thanks a lot. I appreciate you coming on the show today. So, when I look at Mohammad Reza Shajarian, I think he experienced pretty much all the important periods of Iranian history, which really puts them on an interesting spot, doesn't it? So let's just go through them together. The revolution in 1979, how did it influence his music, you think?
So Shajarian was born in 1940. He grew up during the Shah's time. And he was already a very popular singer by the time the Islamic Revolution happened. And as all Iranians, we can say, there was an initial enthusiasm in his music for the revolution. So he kind of delivered a soundtrack for this revolution. So the songs at that time, they were full of enthusiasm, full of hope. But as we know, as years passed, the initial enthusiasm made way to a phase of, of becoming disillusioned, basically.
Mm-hmm. And I mean, we briefly mentioned it before the interview on Showcase, but the banning of Western music after the revolution, it really made him more of a star, didn't it?
Yes. So during the Shah's time, there was a lot of pop music that was very popular in Iran. But Persian classical music continued to play an important role in the Islamic Republic. So he was, by all means, he was the most popular singer after the revolution and continued to be until his death.
Mm-hmm. And let's talk about what happened in 2009 when he voiced his support for the dissident groups. He really got a banned from performing in Iran. So I wonder whether this influenced his career path.
Yes, for the last 11 years of his life, he was not allowed to perform on stage in Iran. And this, of course, deeply saddened him. But at the same time, I would say he was not a political activist. He was more than that. So he was just following his conscience. I would say that he had a very deep sense of humanity, which made him express this solidarity with the protesters in 2009. And of course, he continued to be there. He continued to make his voice heard and he continued to sing. Mm-hmm. But not being able to perform in Iran, of course, was a deep blow for him.
Of course. You said that he wasn't a political activist, but he was quite politicized. So this is something that I want to understand. For his audience, it really sounds to me like he was listened to by all walks, all layers of the society, regardless of their political opinions. So how did this come into being? A dissident figure, I mean, he was considered a dissident figure after 2009, I assume, being listened to by everyone in the society. So can you please tell us how that came into being?
Yes, to understand his popularity, we need to say what makes him unique. He really united all the 83 million Iranians, no matter which political or religious views they subscribe to. First of all, he was a master that you get maybe once in 100 years. So he was so highly evolved in the mastery of his voice. You see, Persian classical music is a very complex and very complicated musical genre. And he really mastered that to the highest level. Also, because he embodied this connection of Iranians with their poets. You know, Iranians love their poets, especially Saadi, Hafiz, Maulana Rumi. So he carried this heritage into the 21st century. But also what we need to add is that he was an ustad in the real sense, which means he was not only a master of music and of his craft, but he also embodied this art in his own personality. And people loved him for his personality, for his high moral standards, for his ethics, for his great humanity. And you could really feel this whenever he entered stage. It was not so much about him showing off his personality as an artist, but he really became almost like a pure channel for this divinely inspired music.
Mm-hmm. Okay, speaking of his personality, you met him in person, right? So can you please tell us what kind of a sort of vibe did he give around?
Yes, I met him twice. The first time was 2011 in Berlin. That was already in the time when he was banned from performing in Iran. So he was touring through Europe. And I was struck most of all by his humility. He had a very humble way to carry himself, very softly spoken, very simple. You wouldn't imagine that in front of you there was the greatest maestro of Persian music of the 20th and 21st century. So that really touched me. And it told me something of the real meaning of an artist.
All right, Marian, thanks for sharing your thoughts with us today. It was lovely having you.